We're going to announce today to talk about 7.5. 7.5 and 7.6 are both solving rational equations. So first key thing you need to make sure you differentiate here is that these are solving problems. The directions will say solve, not simplify. Huge difference. These will also be equations. So my goal for these problems is to get x equals or y equals. I want to get an actual solution set. So on these problems, I can get rid of the denominator by clearing it. So when it says solve, just as we did back on test one, you can multiply through every term and clear the denominators, but that's really important. So I need to differentiate. That's again a big piece. I've said this throughout. There is one set of rules for 7172. When you can put it in a multiplication problem, we factor everything and we cancel. 7.3 and 7.4 was simplifying, adding and subtracting, and we had to keep the denominator. And this section, we're solving. So first step here, and again, this is actually on in Canvas under the extra resources, a summary page PDF. So find the LCD, just like we did in the last sections, but when we're going to write down the LCD like we did. But this is going to be the key new step. We're going to now also write down restrictions, which is tied back to section 7.1 with our domain. We are going to clear the denominators. And again, this is probably the most important step to be very careful on. We're going to multiply every term by the LCD. Underline your terms so you don't miss one. We are then going to solve the resulting equation. This may be a quadratic. Most of the time, it's going to be a linear equation, which is what's written down in green. But if it comes out to be a quadratic, which means I have an x squared, remember this is 6.6, which you're tested on this test. You must set everything equal to zero, factor, and solve. Last step, you should always check your answer, but minimum, I do this differently than she does if you watch her videos. This is why I write my restrictions down at the beginning, because I should always check that. If I get a restriction which makes the denominators equal to zero, it can't work. Sometimes we create that as an answer, but we have to cross it out. So I do this as a minimum check. Best check would be to plug it back in. So we're going to go to 7.5 now. Solving again. This is actually back to our handout for our lectures. This is the part you're supposed to be writing and taking notes on. Again, all that you see up above here is stuff that we have already discussed. So first step we're going to do, number one, figure out what our LCD is. And there's only one denominator here, so it's y. And remember, our denominators cannot equal zero, which is the same thing as saying my LCD cannot equal zero. So that's my restrictions. I put that as my extra piece in my box because that's something I'm going to have to check. So I'm going to rewrite the problem so you can clearly see what I'm doing. And again, if I were writing this problem on paper, I would leave space. So I'm going to now multiply each term by the LCD. And we have three terms here. So I'm going to multiply by y, y, and y. Has to be every term. Don't do this step in your head. She's going to show it as multiplying the whole thing by y and skip the step of what I've written down below. Your choice, what makes sense. But if you do this step correct, you should end up with no denominators left. So we end up with 7y minus 6 equals 9y. I'm now going to collect my like terms onto one side. So I'm going to subtract 7y from both sides. I get a negative 6 equals 2y. And now I'm going to solve this again by dividing both sides by 2. So I get negative 6 divided by 2, which gives me a negative 3. Absolute check that you need to do is what I call a minimum check. And I will always draw this arrow to make sure I'm checking it. It is not a restriction. The best check is to plug it back into the original problem. So I would do 7 minus 6 over negative 3. So that would end up being 7 plus 2, which equals 9, which is my check. But a minimum check should be that it's not a restriction. Anytime during this video, please stop it, pause it, see if you can follow through on the steps. So my LCD for number 2, I only have one denominator again, which is 4x minus 9. That 4x minus 9 cannot equal 0. I'm going to show that over here just to show you how I'm doing this. So I add 9 to both sides, divide by 4. So my restrictions are x cannot equal 9 fourths. If I get 9 fourths as an answer, I have to cross it out. So I'm now going to multiply each term by the 4x minus 9. So 4x minus 9 on the left-hand side, 4x minus 9 on the right-hand side. These 4x minus 9s cancel. I'm left with a 5 on the left-hand side. Be careful. Probably most common mistake here is to not distribute that negative across. So I end up with a negative 4x plus 9. I'm now going to subtract 9 from both sides to isolate x by itself. So when I subtract 9 from both sides, and I generally show more of these steps on my written out format. So I'm going to subtract 9 from both sides, which gives me a negative 4x equals a negative 4, sorry, a negative 4 equals negative 4x. And so now I'm going to divide both sides by a negative 4. Remember, negative divided by negative is a positive 1. Absolute check, as a minimum check, should be, is it not a restriction? So I will always draw my arrow up. She is not going to show the restrictions in a box because she thinks, again, rightfully so, the best check is to plug it back in and make sure it works. But I know that most of you aren't going to take that extra step. So this is a super important check because if you tell me that a restriction is an answer, the whole problem is wrong because that's a really, really important idea for this section. So it's not a restriction. Again, the best check would have been to plug it back in. And it would work if we plug it back in. My answer here is 1. Going to number 3. Number 3, we have 3 terms and they all have denominators. So I need to LCD between all of those. So my LCD here in this case, and again I'm looking at the 5x, the 3x, and the 45, would be 45x. Because remember, we're building it so that they all would match. So if it was just the first two, it would have been 15x. But I need to include the 45 as well. So 45 can't equal 0, but x here is my restriction. I can't have a 0 for my denominator because that would make these first two denominators equal to 0. So I'm going to take again a step. Again, I want you to actually pause this and see if you can walk yourself through this problem on your own first. Make sure you're showing all of your steps. Some of y'all will need to show more steps than I'm showing on my tablet right now. So I'm going to multiply each term here by 45x, every single term. 5x goes into 45x, and it leaves you with a 9, so I'm left with a 6 times 9, which is 54. My second piece here, 3x goes into 45x, that's going to leave me with a 15, so I have a negative 2 times 15, which should give me a negative 30. And for this right-hand term, the 45s cancel. Be careful, it's a negative 8x that I'm left with. So again, some of you will skip the step in between. Some of you will need to show that step. So I should end up with 54 minus 30 equals a negative 8x. These are already like terms on the same side, so I'm going to go ahead and simplify that. Gives me a 24 equals a negative 8x. Divide both sides by a negative 8. That gives me a negative 3 equals x. Minimum check. Always check it's not a restriction, which it's not. The best check would be to plug it back in and make sure it works. My solution set is a negative 3. Going to number 4. My LCD for this problem. I have an x minus 3 and I have an x. They don't match, so I need both of them. If I were to set this equal to 0 using 6.6 rules, x cannot equal 0 from this first piece, and x cannot equal 3 from my second factor. If I get either one of those as the answer, I have to cross them out. So I'm now going to again rewrite it. I'm going to multiply each term by x times x minus 3. And so here I'm going to get 5x squared minus 15x, because again I have to distribute this 5x to both pieces On the second term, the x minus 3's cancel, and I'm left with 4x times x, which gives me 4x squared. And on the third term, the x's cancel, and I'm left with 7x minus 21. So I distributed there. So I'm going to go back here and make sure you're clear to see what I did. Here I did 4x times x. Here I distributed, and the first term as well. So you should see right here, I got a quadratic. If I get a quadratic, I need to move everything to one side and set it equal to 0. So I'm going to subtract 4x squared from both sides. So when I subtract that, I get an x squared. I'm going to subtract 7x from both sides. So that gives me a negative 22x. And then I need to move the 21 over. So I'm going to add it to both sides. I'm going to put it up here just so you can see that that's what I just did there for that. So now I've got it equal to 0. I'm back to 6.6 at this point, which says factor completely. Has to be an x, has to be a negative and a negative because I match the signs. I could have tried 3 and 7. That's not going to work. So it's 1 times 21. Set each one equal to 0. So I get x equals 1, x equals 21. Look up here. Make sure it's not a restriction. I will tell you if it's a quadratic, a lot of times you have to be careful. There may be one answer that is actually a restriction. So my answer here is 1 and 21. Doesn't matter the order. Do not put parentheses. This is not an ordered pair. These are two separate solutions.